Before I start this video, I know what you're thinking. Where's your memes? I will make more, just this time I had a really good video idea and decided to make it now. Some more of my videos might be like this, but I'll keep the memes too. This also is not my real voice, so don't mind the weird one. Anyway, let's get into the video. Early days. Between 1987 to 1996, Jimmy Urine and his brother recorded over 30 songs which were different in musical style, which is how the start of Mindless Self-Indulgence began. Mindless Self-Indulgence is an American electro-punk rock band that first got together in New York City in 1997. The band started with vocalist Jimmy Urine, guitarist Steve Ree, bassist Vanessa Y.T., and drummer Kitty. According to some websites, it says Kitty is Jimmy's cousin. In 1997 they released a demo album called Crappy Little Demo, and their first concert was November in 1998. In 1999 they released an album called Tight, consisting of an electronic rock sound, and with some strange lyrics. Jimmy says some things that are offensive, containing slurs, but Jimmy Urine said that he is not a racist, nor a pedophile, and his lyrics are jokes. And at this time people knew that it was shock value and satirical. Cool era. In the year 2000, Mindless Self-Indulgence made their next album called Frankenstein Girls Will Seem Strangely Sexy. The next year, bassist Vanessa Y.T. left for some reasons. Some people say that she left to become an astronaut, and some others say she left to start a family. It has been confirmed by Kitty that she has children now. Soon, Vanessa Y.T. was replaced by Lindsay. Since their last album was finished early, Jimmy Urine and Steve Ree decided to mess around in the studio to create an album. They called their band The Left Rights, and made their first album self-titled. They had even more strange lyrics about random crap. Rise in success. In 2005, Mindless Self-Indulgence's next album was released. It was called You'll Rebel to Anything. This album was successful and had popular songs like Shut Me Up, Straight to Video, and Stupid MF. This is when they started to become even more known. In 2007, bassist Lindsay married My Chemical Romance singer Gerard Way. My Chemical Romance was a more well-known band at the time, so Mindless Self-Indulgence gained popularity as well. The next year, MSI released their best album. Well, in my opinion, it's called If. This album had really cool songs and the electronic sound went absolutely perfect with the punk sound. This album became pretty popular as well. A lot of the lyrics were still questionable, but funny. This album was released slightly early, so around 2010, The Left Rights made their return with a new album called Bad Choices Made Easy. Like the last one, the songs were weird as hell. The lyrics were obviously satire on this one, especially with the song, I'm on crack, and Fart Doody and a Cocky Pee. Yes, these are real songs. I'm not even lying, these songs are pretty catchy, great songs even though they're about being on crack and literal poop. In 2013, Mindless Self-Indulgence made another album called How I Learned to Stop Giving a Shit and Love Mindless Self-Indulgence. This album really upped the electronic sound, more weird lyrics, but it was more similar to Jimmy's solo music. In 2014, MSI went on hiatus from touring. In these concerts they played I'm on Crack from The Left Rights and more pretty great songs. The next year they released an album called Pink of unreleased songs. Controversy starts. Before 2019, people started recognizing MSI more, and things got pretty crazy. People were offended by their lyrics and allegations came out about band members. There's an amount that is false, but others aren't likely to be, especially the allegations about Jimmy. But it doesn't end there. In a past live stream with Jimmy Urine and Chantal Claret, they both explained some of MSI's songs more in depth. One person in the live stream chat asked a question about the song, Panty Shot, a song with pedophilic-like lyrics. Chantal explains that you can write songs in different perspectives. Jimmy even said, you can write a song in the perspective of a serial killer.
The most is Panty Shot. Because yeah. They're like, why are you writing about that? And it's like, you can write from the perspective of somebody else.
You can write from
idiots.
Serial killers, you can write from whatever you want.
Yeah, fucking idiots.
Jimmy has explained that this song was not about him multiple times. The song was also Jimmy's brother's idea, Marcus Uringer. This song was obviously satire, but Jimmy still has joked about pedophilia a lot in the past. When 2019 came, there was still people who hated MSI and there were people who loved it. This is when people started calling Jimmy problematic. Jimmy made a solo album and when he saw people calling him this, he made a song about it called Problematic. The lyrics were pretty literal, and instead of Jimmy seeing them as thinking he's a bad person, he saw them using the term as a way to say he's just a part of the problem and not a part of a solution. There was allegations about other members too, but they're from Tumblr, Reddit, and Jessica Adams, so I'd take those with a grain of salt. Besides those, I'm sure the allegations did affect people's views on the other members as well since they were associated with Jimmy. In 2020, the members were active again on social media. The YouTube channel posted some funny stuff from Jimmy. The Mindless Self-Indulgence YouTube channel is definitely owned by Jimmy considering the funny crap he posted of himself. In this year with all the crazy stuff going on, MSI became popular on TikTok, and Jimmy even made a reaction video. I kid you not, this 50-year-old dude actually made a video reacting to TikToks about his band. Fast forward to 2021, the members are still slightly active on Twitter and Instagram until one day, which was August 8th. This is the day that killed Mindless Self-Indulgence. On this day, vocalist Jimmy Urine has been sued for the alleged sexual battery of a minor. This was not a TikTok rumor. This was a real lawsuit that he got. The song Panty Shot was probably satire, but it is likely that Jimmy turned the other way and actually did this. Plaintiff Jane Doe claims that she and Jimmy had a sexual relationship from 1997 to 1999. This means at the time she was 15, and Jimmy was 27. He even allegedly gave her a fake ID so she could go to his concerts and drink alcohol with him. I will not go into detail, but I will put the link in the description. I do believe Jane Doe. However, I do find it a bit strange how they used lyrics as evidence, and an advertisement for a drummer that was obviously a joke. Maybe Jimmy made it seem like he was just joking about these things, but he actually was with this girl. Maybe he thought it was right, or he was just an idiot. After this lawsuit, Jimmy disables his comments, went silent from social media, and posted nothing. Right now there is a small community of Mindless Self-Indulgence fans, and it is not as big of a band as it was. None of the members are active on Twitter. Lindsay has changed her Instagram bio from Mindless Self-Indulgence Bassist to just Bassist, and is mainly known as an artist now. She's the only one to post anything since that lawsuit, but with limited comments. Nothing's been heard of from the members besides that ever since August 2021. It was upsetting for a lot of fans, and most either don't care because Jimmy's getting very little money, or just pirate their music now. In the song, It Gets Worse, by Mindless Self-Indulgence, Jimmy says this. Because it doesn't get better unless you're pretty. It doesn't get better unless you've got money. That did not age well for Jimmy at all. And I'm sorry, but I find that hilarious. There really isn't any conclusion. It's all up to you, and you can leave your opinions in the comments. I do think that the allegations in the lawsuit are true, and the rest is pretty confusing, but I don't think Jimmy is really a great guy. I don't think the other members are responsible for what he did, but that's a different story. What do you think of Jimmy's case? Again, you can put your opinions in the comments. Thanks so much for watching this video. I worked really hard on it. Goodbye.